I welcome you all for class 7 subject science. So we will continue our topic, that is heat. So we were talking about the clinical thermometer. The temperature of every person may not be 37 degree. It could be slightly higher or slightly lower. Actually, that we call normal temperature is the average body temperature of a large number of healthy person, that is 37 degree. The clinical thermometer is designed to measure the temperature of human body only. The temperature of human body normally does not go below 35 degrees Celsius or above 42 degrees Celsius. That is the reason that this thermometer has the range of 35 degrees to 42 degrees Celsius. Now, can we use the same thermometer for measuring the other things? Do you use a clinical thermometer for measuring the temperature of any other object other than the human body? No, we will not use that. So what is the next we are using? So these are the different types of laboratory thermometer. What is the laboratory thermometer? Again, it is measured. Different types of thermometers are used for different purposes. The maximum and minimum temperature of the previous day reported in the weather reports are measured by thermometer called the maximum minimum thermometer. Now here you can see it is a laboratory thermometer. The range of laboratory thermometer is generally from 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. As you did it in the case of clinical thermometer, find out how much a small division on this thermometer reads. You would need this information to read the thermometer correctly. In addition to the precautions to be taken while reading a clinical thermometer, the laboratory thermometer should be kept upright, not tilted. Okay, as you can see in the picture, you can keep upright, not tilted, this side, that side. The bulb should be surrounded from all sides by the substance of which the temperature is to be measured. The bulb should not touch the surface of the container. As you can see, I have kept the laboratory thermometer in the water, measuring the water, so that bulb should not touch the beaker there. So after that, keeping it for 5 minutes, you have to keep, and then remove the thermometer and see whether what is the temperature of that water. That's how we will take for all the objects we can keep and measure. So here you can see the other type of thermometer. As I said you, that clinical thermometer contains mercury. Mercury not fall or rise in a clinical thermometer when taken out of the mouth. And this mercury is very toxic, therefore we cannot keep it properly. What is the use of a kink? It prevents mercury level from falling on its own. Okay. So, in the clinical thermometer, there are many drawbacks. So, therefore, nowadays, they have started with what? With the digital thermometer. As you can see in the picture, this is the digital thermometer. Anyone can just see the number and say easily without seeing the small points and all. Just here directly, the numbers are given. So, we can say how much the temperature is. There is a lot of concern over the use of mercury in thermometers. Mercury is a toxic substance and is very difficult to dispose of if a thermometer breaks. These days, digital thermometers are available which do not use mercury. Okay, these are the use of digital thermometer which now commonly we are using. It is easy to measure the temperature of our body. Okay, how do you think the transfer of heat takes place from the water to the thermometer? The heat is transferred from the pan of the surrounding, so you can understand that in both the cases, means what we are seeing here, that the water, the temperature of the water is flowing to the thermometer. the heat flows from a hotter object to a colder object. In fact, in all the cases, heat flows from a hotter object to a colder object. Okay, heat will flow from hot to cold. So you can see here what it is: flow of heat through a metal strip. Take a rod of flat strip of metal, say of aluminium or iron. Fix a small wax piece on the rod. These pieces should be at nearly equal distance. Clamp the rod up to a stand, as you can see in the picture. If you do not find a stand, you can put one end of the rod in between bricks. Now heat the other end of the rod and observe what happens to the wax pieces. Do these pieces begins to fall? Which piece falls the first? So, what do you think the heat is transferred from the end nearest to the flame to the other end? Yes, it is passing from the heat, that is from the candle. The heat is passing from one end to the other end. As you can see, the wax is melting and moving to the other end. The process by which heat is transferred from the hotter end to the colder end of an object is known as conduction. What is conduction? The process by which heat is transferred from the hotter end to the colder end of an object is known as conduction. In solids, generally the heat is transferred by the process of conduction. Clear?